The brain is everything. The brain is the thing that controls all of our movements every day. Our brains are continuously kind of adapting to the environment and what's going on.
So can you tell me a bit about what your study is?
These two parts of the brain are very involved in motor control and motor learning, and we're particularly interested in motor learning. We want to look at how their learning may be influenced by reward and how those kind of rewards kind of interact with the kind of learning by error. There are kind of two forms of motor learning. One is based on error, so when you make a mistake, you kind of correct for it, and we think that the cerebellum's very much involved in that. Okay. And the other kind of learning is based on reward. So if you get rewarded, you make a better movement the next time around, right? And one of the structures we know that is heavily involved in learning through reward, which is called reinforcement learning, is the basal ganglia. And the chemical in the basal ganglia, the neurotransmitter, is dopamine. Absolutely. People with Parkinson aren't as good at being able to see the contextual cues and switch on the appropriate movement. And again, we think that is to do with the fact that their reward system aren't functioning as well as they should be.
When you say rewards, what do you mean? Are you talking about giving me a cookie if I...
Well, it's a difficult... I mean, a lot of our knowledge about how reward signals and systems work is done in animals, right? In rats. Because we have a big brain. I think the human brain is very quick at associating a reward to anything you want. So if I tell you to do a task and say, if you do it well, you're going to get a nice sound,
right?
Then you're going to go, right, okay, I want to do this well.
Right.
And so actually getting it right in itself is a reward. As long as there's a signal at the end that says you've got it right, that's
correct,
a reward itself. But we do use very simple rewards. So when you get it, you'll see in a minute, when you get the task right, you get a nice little firework display in the screen.
It's like playing a video game. Like,
it's exactly
like playing a video game. When you don't have any like tangible reward, yeah, except just knowing that, oh, I did something great.
And or you beat the big boss at the end.
I know.
Come and take a seat.
Oh,
does it
me?
Look like a robot, yeah, to you, Omotola?
No, I actually, it well, does not.
No, I mean, people think it's going to be like a robot, but it's not. It is a mechanical device that's controlled by a computer, which is essentially a definition of a robot. So this robot allows you to apply forces to the limb as they move through space. So as we reach, the idea is that you make a movement towards yourself, and it's a straight line, and that's the task. It's so simple, right. You make a straight line. But at a certain point during the task, you get a force field which pushes your arm off to one side, and the idea of the task, it's like a video game, is to try and make a straight movement. So there's a handle of a robot in front of you. You can see the dots, right? If you go,
yes,
to the dots furthest away from you, and then when it goes blue, move to the one closest to you as quickly as possible in a straight line. And if you get it right, you get a little fireworks display. That was the reward, right?
It's fun, I'm smiling.
There you go.
I'm trying to connect the dots, and the machine is applying different forces, making it more difficult for me. And the more I repeat the movement, the easier it is for me to control what I'm doing. When it was easier, I was able to connect the dots without having to think about it. What he's trying to do is try to help us to find ways to correct some of our movement dysfunctions, for lack of a better term. I think the concept here is through repeated movement, the brain to find a way to learn those movements. It's quite a bit of work because I'm having to hold the joystick down, and there is some force that it's pushing back at me. You want to win. I want to overcome the challenge that it presents. So there has to be a way to transfer that into my everyday life without me having to play a video game for 3 hours.